And it is the most wonderful time of the year, and we are so fortunate to live near what Travel and Leisure has named one of America's best towns for the holidays. Of course, we are talking about Newport, and Michaela is live there all week from the Breakers for Christmas at the Mansions. Good morning, Michaela.
Hey, good morning. Day two at the Breakers, and the fun has not stopped. You can experience a lot here during the holiday season, so we've brought in the director of museum experience, John Rodman. Welcome.
Good morning, Michaela. Welcome to the house that Vanderbilt built.
Good point. This is such a massive home, and I know that it was home to a lot of great parties when it was in its heyday.
Oh, yes, absolutely. There were weddings here. A number of the daughters had coming out parties. Mm-hmm. There were a lot of regular, you'll pardon the expression, parties as well throughout the summer. So the Great Hall of the Breakers was a busy place.
This is also a busy place during the holiday season. We can kind of party here and experience it in a different light. So take us through some of the holiday events.
Sure. Well, okay, let's start with the fact that the Breakers, the Elms and Marble House, are open Monday through Friday, mm-hmm. every day through the 3rd of January, decorated for Christmas. So that's the first part that's really fun. Also, Rosecliff is going to open up the end of next week, mm-hmm. and the special exhibition that is there right now will be continued, and it's going to go on through January 3rd.
Wow.
So that's special right there. Mm-hmm. Then we have our holiday evenings. Now, the holiday evenings are a whole different experience because, I mean, as you look around here and you look at this space, usually, but usually we have the ropes up, mm-hmm. and you have to kind of follow the red rope and so forth.
Sure.
Holiday evenings, we take the rope down. You can go anywhere you want to. And you kind of get the feeling of being a guest.
Yeah.
And then we have refreshments of all kinds. Mm-hmm. So people get to enjoy kind of a real house party feel. And we bring in music. And that's from 6 to 8. And we're doing that this coming Saturday and next Saturday. And then the 26th. On the 19th, we break out of this building, mm-hmm. and we have two parties the same night.
Wow.
And we do that at the Elms and Marble House.
There's also a shuttle, too, that will run between both if you want to experience a little of everything.
On the 19th, we have a shuttle, and it's one admission for both houses.
Great.
So you don't have to pick and choose. It's one price, mm-hmm. and it's all fun.
Is this something that only adults can partake in just because it's, you know, it's a little later? You're talking about, like, cocktails and music?
Actually, no. The kids can come.
Great.
The kids can come. There are some adult refreshments. There are some mm-hmm. youngster refreshments. So we're very careful about how those get separated. But, no, bring the kids. This is absolutely for them. In fact, upstairs, and I know that we're going to take a look at that later on, mm-hmm. but upstairs we have a wonderful train set that is mixed in with our gingerbread house exhibition, mm-hmm. because we've had local bakers do versions of Chateau Sur Mer, King's Coat, Rosecliff, and so there was a competition, and we know who won, so mm-hmm. there'll be an announcement about that. But that's just, that's all fun for the kids.
Yeah, it's nice. You've really kind of accommodated everyone. And to take us out of the really tour mentality that we're so used to when we come to the Mansions, and to be able to feel like we're part of the Gilded Age.
Well, that's what we want. The whole point here is that the house was created as a house where there would be entertainment, where there'd be a lot of fun. And so that's why they built it. Mm-hmm. Let's keep on using it for that.
You talk about keep on using it. You can actually keep experiencing it even after the holidays, right?
Well, that's right. The Breakers, Elms, and Marble House are going to be open year-round from now on.
Great.
So if you don't get here, now I can't imagine why you wouldn't get here.
But
if you
can't get here, around the holidays.
Well, it can. But if you don't get here during the holidays, then you can see those houses later on in the season. The other thing we've got are the Santa Sundays.
Perfect.
So at the Breakers, then at Marble House, then at the Elms on consecutive Sundays, starting this Sunday, Santa will be there for the kids to see from noon to 3.
Perfect. All right. Sounds like there's something every single day. I know we threw a lot of dates at you, but if you want any more information, you know you can go to our website for that. And we're going to have plenty more from the Breakers when we come back.
And welcome back, everybody. Besides the beautiful decorations at the Newport Mansions during this holiday season, there is so much history to take in while you're there. Michaela joins us live with a glimpse at some of that history. Good morning, Michaela.
Yeah, that's right. Well, you can see a lot of history when you're taking a tour of any of the mansions, but we're about to show you some stuff that you may never have a chance to see. So processing archivist Paul Caserta is here to tell us a bit more. Processing archivist, let's start there. What is it that you do?
Absolutely, and good morning. What I do is I create and manage, including preserving and creating access to historic collections of any types. Now, that can be anything from historic photographs to manuscripts, rare books. It's quite a vast variety of items.
You've brought a variety of items with you. So can you take us through what you've brought? Let's start here with
Absolutely.
Is this music?
It is. This is sheet music. This is from our music collection from the archives, mm-hmm. Which might have belonged to the Vanderbilt family. We are not sure. It is in German, and it is called, for the translation, Christmas Chimes. Yes, I don't speak German myself, so I wouldn't know. But these are certain segments for piano. This piece in particular is a nocturne that would have been played during the holidays.
Fun. How old is this?
This is from around 1906.
Oh my gosh.
The illustrations on the front is actually designed in Paris and
Beautiful.
Is an Art Deco style from around 1899.
All right. Now, going a little older than that, too, is this book right here?
Yes. This book, which is actually a collection of illustrated newspaper clippings from London, mm-hmm. is called Holiday Book in Christmas and the New Year. So pretty much it was a celebration of different types of folklore and music, poems, literature of all different styles. And as you can see from some of these illustrations here, some of them are quite fascinating. Flipping through it, I've seen anything from knights fighting crocodiles to different types of old folklore themes like Father Christmas.
Beautiful stuff. No, like Christmas time is the perfect time to send out all your greeting cards. I'm sure a lot of people
Absolutely.
Are hurrying to get those in the mail soon.
Yes, and indeed. And these are from approximately the 1920s from the families that lived in Rosecliff and also the Breakers here. We have different postcards, greeting cards that from about the 1920s. And as you can see from some of the styles, a lot of them are European in nature with gold mm-hmm. leaf, different type of letterpress. But it was such an art style to it during the time.
And they're so well preserved too, including this book right here by a very popular author that we may recognize.
It is. I couldn't see it from here. Rudyard Kipling, his book Rewards and Fairies. This book was given to Cornelius Vanderbilt IV around 1910. His mother was a friend of the person who gave it to him, which as you can see from this little note card on here, she actually put her own name on it.
Wow.
Mrs. Nicholas Longworth.
Great. And then finally, this is something that we may actually see in one of the mansions,
Yes, we do have some different types of decorations as you go between the mansions mm-hmm. and other properties that we own. This one is from an American illustrated newspaper. It is a scene depicting the Rhode Island Regiment during the Civil War
wow.
that were going off.
So lots of history that can all be found in the mansions, outside of the mansions. They're keeping really good care of this, too. If you want to visit the mansions, come on out. Join us all week long. Guys, back to you.